Larry calling in from Pennsylvania. And by the way, folks, we have a couple of open lines, so please feel free to call in. Larry, you're live on Truth Wanted. What's up?
Hello?
Hello, Larry. You are live. What's good?
Everything. How are you?
Doing great. Hosting Truth Wanted with Dave Farina. Having a good night. How could we help?
Well, not to get on too many, tangents. I was just wondering, because you've spoken many times of being a person of faith, and I don't look down on that. You know what I mean? I'm definitely an atheist, but part of like believing in the Jesus mythology, and I'm not going to go on, farther than that. Did you really believe that when you passed away, there would be this kind of, spirit would rise up above you and that you would live forever? Because that seems to be the promise of Christianity.
Yeah. You know, when I was a Christian, I went through a lot of different phases of Christianity because there's a lot of different philosophical traditions.
And I'm not demeaning that notion.
Sure. Sure. Yeah. I mean, I'm not a Christian anymore. And so if I was, I mean, when I was, I kind of went through different phases. I guess I had an idea of sort of a spiritual dimension, like heaven was in another dimension, kind of. I think that was kind of my view of it, because it's certainly not in the clouds, right? Like we went up there. Yeah. It's nobody not there. Up there. although I feel now that that's actually
in Judaism, and there was no reason to like put our faith down per se, if that makes any kind of sense.
I'll tell you this, I think different spiritual traditions think differently about this. I don't know if there's a unified cosmology in Christianity or Judaism, but to answer your question, I thought that there was a component of me that was spiritual. I mean, I'm not the only person to have ever thought this. There's a lot of philosophers in Western history. I think it was it Descartes that thought, was like the first one to talk about the human soul in a lot of depth? I know, or maybe Thomas Aquinas talked about it in Summa Theologica, but it's in there. But the point is, I had this idea that there was a separate spiritual part of me, and I did think it was going to go to a heaven somewhere. I don't know how that worked. I don't know how that would function, but yeah, that was definitely a belief of mine.
I think Descartes thought it was in the pineal gland.
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah. As an adult, the whole notion that it's like, so what you're telling me is, if I believe in this, I'm going to exist forever. And I'm like, it's a beautiful life. It's full of gorgeousness. It's full of challenges and this and that. But if you think it's going to go on forever, I might have to disagree with you.
Yeah, I mean, I agree with you because I've never observed a mind outside of a body. Right. And that's what I tell people. Like, I don't know how a conscious being could function without the physical processes necessary for consciousness to happen. We don't know everything about it. We don't know exactly how it all works, but we can definitely tell that it comes from physical processes because we've done tests on humans and animals and all kinds of stuff to show how different parts of the brain work with the rest of the body. And how our sensory organs work and stuff. So, yeah, I don't think there is a consciousness or a being outside of the physical realm. Do you feel that way too, Dave, or what's your take?
Yeah, I'm a reductionist, so I don't believe in a soul. And I also think that people who subscribe to an afterlife haven't really thought it through. All right, who's talking?
I'm loving this life as much. I don't mean to interrupt you. As much as I can, but there's a certain part of me that believes that, our final moment is oblivion, but the better you live your life, the more that you win at you know, what we could possibly be. Because there's no reason to be afraid of the end. We, you know, if you've ever watched the movie Blade Runner, where they talk about, you know, they only have 4 years to live.
Yeah, it's a nice thought, Larry. It really is a nice thought. Like, I wish more people would kind of view life that way, because when I was a Christian, and I this isn't the view of all Christians, but when I was a Christian, I did have this idea that, well, you know, I may be overweight now, or I may have this bad part of me now, or maybe this part of my life isn't now, but when I get to heaven, things will get better for me. And so I don't have to improve my current circumstances, or I don't have to work towards this thing, because, you know, I'm kind of like spiritually already taken care of. And I think that's a fallacy. I think that's a wrong way of thinking.
You can be a horrible person because you believe in Jesus and you're going to go to heaven anyway. As long as you repent.
It turns out your religious beliefs don't actually determine whether or not your ethics are in play.
Anything, there's an inverse correlation, I think, sometimes.
Yeah. I mean, depending on the branch there. But yeah, like, how do you feel about that, Dave, about, you know, death and you know, the realization of our own mortality as kind of material beings?
Well, it's the human condition.
Yeah,
the human condition is to have the cognitive ability to recognize the difference between infinity and finitude and lament that we are not infinite, you know. But I think that people who want there to be an afterlife actually are just afraid of dying. They don't really want to live forever. They just want to live a little longer. And if you actually thought about it, if you actually were to conceive of the concept of existing infinitely without end, that there wouldn't be anybody that believed in that, because it's not desirable. There would be no difference between heaven and hell. I mean, it's just I find it to be a pretty infantile belief. But everybody can believe whatever they want. You know, I would never strip anyone's beliefs from them, so long as you are not imposing them on society in a disproportionate way. You know.
So. Yeah, it falls apart when you really look at it. I mean, not even just the physical part. Well, even part of the physical parts, right? Because, like, I was a kid at one time, and so my brain literally functioned differently, and the way I thought about things was different. Mm-hmm. And hopefully, if I make it, one day I'll be old, and maybe I'll have some sort of cognitive decline. So, like, if I go into an afterlife in that state,
you'll regret.
Like, am I going to be like that, you know, or am I going to be like what's the rules there? How does that work? You know,
like in the Good Place. If you ever watched the show, The Good Place,
In
The Good Place, the real Good Place, everybody's just dumb. And actually, what I really liked about The Good Place was that initially I was like, heaven and hell, this is dumb. But I liked how they addressed, when they really got to The Good Place, that actually nobody really wants to exist indefinitely. They all eventually want to go through the gate and stop existing, because it would be torture to exist indefinitely, you know.
And so I'm not afraid of death. I'm really not. I don't know. No. Like I hope it comes quick. I hope I don't have to be scared in my final moments. But I'm really not afraid of what happens. So whatever that might be. Let's go ahead and go to our next caller, though.
Let's get a caller that's not on Quaaludes, please.
Well, I mean, I invite all kinds of people of all walks of life to call into this show. So. Regardless,
more words per minute.
Yeah, well, maybe I don't know if you like this next one here. We'll see.